So the best thing about teaching is probably doing practicals and interactive science shows that we do for children, because these are the way that you get to interact with students and with children directly. And that gives you a real buzz, because you get to be able to watch the students solve problems, discuss their ideas with you, and have that eureka moment when they get the concept that you're trying to teach them. And that's incredibly rewarding. My research is really interesting because you get to take part in the world of another animal. So by watching animals and how they deal with physical problems in their habitat, or how they play with their friends or fight with their enemies, you get to be part of their world. And not only that, because the animals that I'm studying are the great apes, our closest living cousins, our animal cousins, you can then apply all of that information to try and reinterpret how our ancestors lived about 6 million years ago. And that's an incredible insight into our own evolution. What inspires me is when I'm walking along and I catch something out the corner of my eye that's completely unexpected and I don't quite understand it. And it's that addiction that you have when you work in academia to try and explain the things that you don't quite understand. My superhero power. I'm going to give two, and I'm sure you'll edit one out, but I'm going to give two. My first superhero power has to be, the ability to stop the destruction of the rainforests, because we're losing animals that are closely related to us and that are magnificent and inspirational in themselves, and they're going to be wiped out within the next 5 or 10 years. My second superpower would be something like Pongo power, that allowed me to scrap my commute to work on the train and just leap out the train window and leap along the skyline to get to work in record time. Something about myself that very few people know is that when I was at university, I played rugby and my nickname was Smasher Thorpe.